of these bacteria or these harmful microbes, quickly they are growing resistance. There are a number of reasons behind it, particularly developing countries like ours. Indiscriminate use of these antibiotics, number of molecules. So time, it is the right time for awareness and to be alert for us for the consequence of these antibiotic resistance. So there are so many reasons behind it, because you know these are injudicious use, sometimes double antibiotics, sometimes without no, which one is and bacteriostatic, which one is bactericidal. Combining these two judiciously, it is not at all advocated. And secondly, because of the emergence of these bacteria, you know, these are living organisms, everyone has the right to live. So they try to raise certain toxic
substances. You all said it may not be possible sometimes. But I personally believe that it is of this government to ensure everybody, my students, my SR and all, to minimize the process drug as far as possible and spectrum set also you should look into that. So there is no exact policy trained by the department.
So we have to come out these things. We should follow evidence-based practice of medicine. Particularly in we have seen in our department also for acute pancreatitis, meropenem is prescribed, while there is no role of antibiotics in pancreatitis. So we should first be evidence-based and be scientific, and also we should have to follow the basic principles of surgery, like tissue respectability, hemostasis, etc. And there is no, in modern day surgery, there is no place for hardiness. Better we should be set so that antibiotic use will be also less, or there won't be any need of antibiotics. Because I have worked in one place where there is no use of antibiotics for routine surgery items. Even then there is no infection. So I think we should start auditing.
I agree, this is the high end, sir. If we don't practice ourselves, then how will we teach our residents and postgraduate students? Is that it, sir?
Yes.
So, Dr. Tapan Madan,
sir. There is a protocol. Like, it is not in regards of medicine only, sir. Even the investigation protocol also. Suppose the patient is coming with pancreatitis, as you are telling, sir, once comes the residence, he or she has to prescribe that medicine only, whatever they put or whatever is the protocol, and investigation to be sent also. So in our institute, what we are seeing, sir, like it is an only use. That one might be reason this is not a one-sided game, because many of the times our supplies are not adequate also. Sometimes we compromise. But compromise becomes in terms of meropenem and imipenem. This is the matter basically in question, sir. Because I have seen even during Ramu also, suppose Joan is there. If some other brand has come, then no one will write. They say it is out of stock. Most probably these things are not even ventilated to the doctors who are prescribing there. So this, we need more organized movement than this will be a surprise. What I thought.
Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, I would like to congratulate the Department of Microbiology for holding such a beautiful series. It is difficult time event, and the attendance you could see, it was very acceptable. My question is standing here actually. The question is, many a time we stand throat swab, we stand oral swab, because nearly we use actually variety of antibiotics. Many of the different kind of antibiotics we use. So we, a lot will depend on the evidence to get from the laboratory. And many other time we discuss with the colleagues that the report comes as like no culture, no growth, like that. So those reports we are discussed.
There are technical reasons also to have this. But my question is, how to go about? Like say, when you have passed there, or say, when you have maintained the councils, or when you have prudent interest in, and then like we have departmental protocol of antibiotic in place, that is there. But when you see that past has been sent or culture has been sent, and the report comes as no growth, that how to come, I do have the point of view, how to go about in those cases. You should have empirical treatment, or how do you suggest us to do? That is my question. And regarding, before I finish, regarding Dr. Bilan's this one, I said, when indiscipline is the rule, sometimes it is very difficult. We have to first think about what is discipline. We have to teach our young generation like the importance of discipline. We have to be disciplined first. Very true, somebody said. When indiscipline is the rule of today, it's very difficult to sometimes, to go about with this. So we have to be disciplined first, then, yes, united movement against this antibacterial resistance will definitely win over this infection. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Dr. Biplab. Regarding his points, one of the very important point is for a particular case, what to do, what not to do. So in that case, what I will suggest for frequent clinical pathological meet, so particular few departments, they can come forward and we medical education unit are there, we will want to support you, okay? So in that platform, you can discuss those cases for your future guideline. Thank you all. And Dr. Tapan Majumdar, I request to just say a few words at the end of this seminar.
Dr. Ozzie has asked and what Dr. Rai has answered, the only thing that I would like to tell is we are extremely sorry that even after 15 years of the establishment of a medical college, we don't have a working culture, proper work culture, mostly in the clinical science center. Because we try to maintain as far as practical. So, hospital has got a hospital infection control committee. Hospital has got a hospital infection control team. Hospital has got a biomedical waste management committee. This was only on papers for last many years. Okay, so recently we tried to, in spite of the COVID commitment also, along with the NS GB Hospital. So we try to activate this, and at two meetings we have organized. There we have decided that every month we will be releasing, as you demanded also, we will be releasing the sample-wise sensitivity pattern and resistance pattern, and we will circulate to all the clinical departments for their ready reference. Now what we decided in that meeting is, if you can generate this sort of data for 12 months, then maybe we are in a position to formulate one guideline that in our setup, these drugs